Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on electricity for class 10 science. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 8th video class we will study topic 12.8 electric power. So as usual, starting with the name itself. Why? Because everything is there in the name. What is the meaning of power? See, power means strength, okay, or you can say that power is the rate of doing work. And when we talk about electricity, this electric power is the combination of voltage and current, or you can say the product of voltage or potential difference and current, V into I. So electric power is the rate per unit time at which electrical energy is transferred by an electric circuit. The SI unit of this electric power is watt, or 1 joule per second. And electric power is usually produced by electrical generators, but can also be supplied by source such as electrical batteries. So let us start. So the definition of electric power is like this: the rate at which the electric energy is consumed or dissipated is called electric power. So rate means at what time, right? So power is equal to W by T, that is work done upon T, or you can say energy per time. But we know that this work done is equal to VQ. Can we write like this? Is equal to VQ divided by T, and you know that Q by T is I, that is current, right? So can I write like this? P is equal to V into I, that is power is equal to potential difference into current. Now V is equal to I into R from Ohm's law. So can I write like this? That P is equal to I into R into I, which is equal to I square R. So P is equal to I square into R. So can I write like this? P is equal to, replacing the value of I from the Ohm's law, that is V by R. Okay, P is equal to V square by R square into R, which is equal to V square by R. Hence we have four equations for power. Number one, P is equal to work done by time. So this is equation one. Second, P is equal to V into I, equation two. Third, P is equal to I square into R. And fourth, P is equal to V square by R. So we can use any of these four equations for solving different examples on power. And the SI unit of this electric power is, from this equation, P is equal to V into I. So lot of work on power was done by watt, and hence the SI unit of this electric power is watt. So how can we define the SI unit of power? The electric power consumed by a device is said to be 1 watt if it carries 1 ampere of current when operated at a potential difference of 1 volt. So 1 watt is equal to 1 volt into 1 ampere. And also from this equation, P is equal to E by T. P is equal to energy or work done per time, and work done is given in joules. So this is joule per second. So 1 watt is equal to 1 joule second inverse. Now this 1 watt unit is very small. So therefore in actual practice, we use a much larger unit called kilowatt, which is equal to 1000 watts. And since the electrical energy is a product of power and time, E is equal to P into T, the unit of electrical energy is therefore watt hour. So you can see here that energy E is the product of power into time. So from this equation, can we write like this? E is equal to P into T, power into time, and therefore it is watt into hour. So 1 watt hour is the energy consumed when 1 watt power is used for 1 hour. But the commercial or practical unit of electric energy is kilowatt hour, kWh, as we saw in our previous video class. So commercial unit is kWh. Why? Because watt hour is also very small for commercial application. 1 kWh is equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. 1 kilowatt means 1000 watts, and 1 hour means 1 hour into 60 minutes into 60 seconds. So this comes out to be 1000 into 3600, which is equal to 3, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or you can write like this, that if I shift the point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 3.6 into 10 raised to 6. 3.6 into 10 raised to 6. And the unit will be watts into seconds. This will be seconds, right? So watt into second. But you can see here that this power P, which is in watts. So watt into second is 1 joule. From this equation, you can see that watt into second is equal to joule, and therefore this is equal to 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joules. So note that the unit kilowatt hour is equal to the electric energy consumed when electric power of 1 kilowatt is consumed for 1 hour. For example, if 10 electric bulbs each of rating 100 watts are used for 1 hour, that is 10 into 100, that is 1000, right? 1 kilo. Then 1 unit of electric energy is consumed. That means 1 kilowatt into 1 hour, 1 kilowatt hour. Now the question may come in your mind that are the electrons consumed in an electric circuit? No. See, electrons are not consumed in an electric circuit. See, we provide the electricity board or electric company to provide electric energy to move electrons through all the electrical gadgets like electrical fan, electric bulb, refrigerator, AC, television, etc. installed in our homes. So we pay for the electric energy that we use. And therefore, the commercial unit of power is 1 kilowatt hour, right? I hope it is clear. Let us go ahead and solve the examples given in your textbook. Example 12.12, an electric bulb is connected to a 220 volts generator. The current is 0.5 ampere. What is the power of the bulb? So what you need to find out? You need to find out power, okay? And what you have? You have voltage, the potential difference, that is 220 volts. And you also have current, I, which is equal to 0.50 amperes. So which equation will we use? Very simple. We will use P is equal to V into I. So always remember, power is equal to energy by time or work done by time, and energy or work done is equal to power into time or joules per second. So can I write like this? 220 into 50 divided by 100. Let us go ahead and solve the next example. An electric refrigerator rated 400 watts operates 8 hours per day. What is the cost of energy to operate it for 30 days at rupees 3 per kilowatt hour? So what is given? The power is given, right? So P is equal to 400 watts and it operates for 8 hours per day. 400 watts into 8 hours per day, and it is asked that what is the cost of energy to operate it for 30 days. We have to operate this 8 hours per day into 30 days. So this is equal to 400 watts into 8 hours upon 1 day into 30 days. This day will get cancelled out, and what we will get is 4 into 8 into 3. So 8 4s are 32, 32 into 3 is 96. So we will get 96000 watts into hours, W into H. But you know that this is 1000, okay? So can we write like this, that power is equal to 96 kilowatt hour. It is consumed for 30 days, right? And it is given that 1 kilowatt hour is having rate of rupees 3. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to rupees 3. Then 96 kilowatt hour is equal to how much money? Let us see the in-text questions of your textbook. Number 1, what determines the rate at which energy is delivered by a current? The electric power of the source determines the rate at which energy is delivered by the current to the load or particular appliance. Whereas the electric power of an appliance determines the rate at which the energy delivered by a current is consumed by the appliance. Okay. Next is, an electric motor takes 5 ampere from a 220 volts line. Determine the power of the motor and the energy consumed in 2 hours. So what is given here? Current is given, I is equal to 5 amperes. Voltage is given, V is equal to 220 volts. And time is given 2 hours, right? T is equal to 2 hours. So always we should convert into seconds. So this is equal to 2 hours into 60 minutes into 60 seconds, which is equal to 7200 seconds. So these things are given, and what is asked? Determine the power of the motor and the energy consumed. Okay, so first you have to determine the power. So power P is simple, V into I, because both are given. So is equal to 220 into 5 So power is 1100 watts. And now energy consumed. We know that energy is equal to power into time from the equation P is equal to E by T, work done or energy by time. So energy is equal to power into time, which is equal to 1100 watts into time is 7200 seconds. Or we can even solve like this, that energy E is equal to P into T, which is equal to 1100 watts into 2 hours. If you want the answer directly in kilowatt hours. So you can see here, you will get the same answer if you convert it, is equal to 2.20. Kilo means 10 raised to 3. Watts is joule per second. 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. 3600 seconds. So this seconds will get cancelled out and you will get 7.92 into 10 raised to 6 joules, because I'll be shifting 6 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These both are same. This one and this one. So you go by any method, your answer will be same. But normally the energy consumed is calculated in terms of kilowatt hours, right? So you can obtain the answer like this. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.